Why do you think it's so important to celebrate the wonderful talent behind the camera as well as in front?
If I'm honest, I think it's more important. They have the ability, everyone who works behind the camera has the ability to make the actors look great or terrible. We're completely in their hands. And there's so many people behind the camera. I don't think audiences necessarily know. They're so used to seeing actors up there being the face of the television industry. And actually, we're nothing without the crew. We really aren't. And, you know, there's always a danger that sounds condescending, but it's the truth, is that they hold all the power in their hands to make us look physically terrible or our performances look terrible or vice versa. So it's essential. They should be the ones on TV at the Royal Albert Hall rather than us.
Where are we going to be seeing you looking good next? What's coming up for you at the moment?
Well, Da Vinci's Demons Season 2 is currently on. It's nominated for a couple of things tonight, which is exciting. And that's currently on Fox in the UK. And then I'm doing a Doctor Who at the moment. There's a movie called Kill Your Friends. And then we hopefully will start Da Vinci's Demons Season 3 if we get the green light sometime soon.
Obviously, the show's been a huge hit. Why do you think fans have responded so well to it, and what are you looking forward to in season 3?
Oh man, well, if we're lucky enough to get one, it'll be just a chance to kind of expand the universe that we've already created. Why have they? I don't know. There's just something. It's a British show. We make it here, and yet it's so. I want to say expensive, but it's unusual to have such a high budget thing on British soil, and it looks like film, it looks like cinema, and the ideas are epic and huge, and it's just rare to have something like that on television. We're very lucky.
What's fans have their favourite episode so far? Are there any that you're particularly proud of or particularly enjoyed making?
Oh man, I love episode 5 of season 2 because we go to Peru in the show, which we shot entirely in Swansea. So hopefully this time next year all our visual effects people will be up doing the same thing up for the BAFTAs, because what they've created in a car factory off the M4 in Wales is suddenly, looks like South America. So,
like you say, the show nominated a number of categories here tonight. Particularly the visual effects on the show are pretty special. Are there any that have particularly blown you away when you've seen the end result?
Oh, that's a good question. I have to go back to Peru, because we were walking along a cliff edge that was a foot off the ground with a green carpet on the floor. I've watched it on the screen. You've got the entire vista of South America. You've got Machu Picchu in the distance. You've got cloud hanging, almost coming across the characters' bodies. It's extraordinary.
Apart from your own, who's your favourite character on the show? Because again, fans have their own favourite.
Well, that's a great question. What's my favourite character? I've got a soft spot for Nico, who's played by Eros Vlahos, who is going to grow into a very interesting character as the season progresses, but it would give away too much if I tell you now. I'm currently shooting Doctor Who with the visual effects team that I've just presented the award to, which was so nice. They'd also worked on Da Vinci, which is a Mark Gatiss written episode, and very exciting, working with Peter Capaldi for the first time as the new Doctor, who I think is going to blow people's minds. And then I've got a film called Kill Your Friends, based on a 90s novel by John Niven about the Britpop industry. So I've been wandering around realising, the sad realisation that the 90s is now a period time and everyone's dressed in period clothes, and to be honest, I'm dressed like I was when I was 15. So,
on the subject of Doctor Who, obviously, Peter, there's so much excitement about him. I mean, what do you think fans can expect from him? I mean, obviously, we know what he can do as a performer, but as the Doctor, I think there's just a lot of excitement for what he's going to do with that iconic role.
I think he's going to tear the time-space continuum a new TARDIS. He's going to be great. I couldn't give away too much about how he's going to do it and what he's going to do it, but having watched him on set, I can't wait to watch him on the screen.
And of course, I mean, the Britpop film, I think a lot of excitement about that. Obviously, the book's been very successful. Where do you fit into that?
I play Tony Parker Hall, who is the nemesis to Nicholas Holt's character, who plays Stelfox, the lead. He is the guy who comes into the A&R company and sort of shakes things up. But there's no one really very nice in the film. It's just a film full of anti-heroes and not really getting their just desserts. It's dark. And everyone keeps asking me, have you toned down the book? And we really haven't. We haven't.